Okay, that is enough of that. Alright guys, welcome to another Kerbal Space Program video. Today we are going to be using the Superior Soviet Russian Space Shuttle, also known as the Buran, to get ourselves up to low carbon orbit and build a space station in low carbon orbit. So first thing I actually want to show off in our ascent is our kind of stupid booster separation. We have to like launch them off the front because we here in Soviet Russia do not use separatrons. We eject our boosters full power off the back or sides of our rocket and we let them fly on up. So this is a recreation of the Buran, also known as the just complete copy of the space shuttle. This thing is very similar to the space shuttle. The Soviets basically just copied it. Arguably it is better just because the Soviets were able to just literally just copy it, and it was, they already had the space shuttle plan, so they really had to do like very little work relative to NASA. So the spacecraft that's being carried on, the booster, you know, the space shuttle, it's all one big system, right? You know, space shuttle orbit, it's all thing. The rocket in the Soviet version is actually known as the Energia or Energia. That sounds kind of weird in my opinion, though. But it is a very, very powerful rocket, as you can see. Instead, the biggest difference between the Buran and the American space shuttle is basically that the American space shuttle has those three engines on the orbiter. The Soviet version has them actually on the big booster. You can actually see it there as we get into orbit now. I see those engines on the bottom. Using four Macedon engines, just as we go ahead and undock there, we have Macedons on the core stage, and then the boosters, which are liquid-fueled, which is another difference. There are four liquid-fuel boosters on the Soviet version, and the U.S. version has two SRBs. So we're just going to go ahead and pop open our cargo bay for the first time, and we can have a look at our first payload of the day. This is a pretty monstrous project to be doing in one video. We're doing seven launches, but I think I was able to edit it down concisely enough so it's not boring. Let me know if it is, so I will hopefully improve for the next video. So we're just going to deploy that first one into low carbon orbit, just leave it there about 100 by 100 kilometer orbit, and then we can just turn our Superior, no, just kidding. That is my Russian accent, it's bad. For everyone's safety, I'm going to stop doing that. So it's going to go ahead and deorbit. We have tiny little engines mounted radially on the spacecraft just to help us deorbit. I forget exactly which ones. It's like the ones that are orange, the radial. I shouldn't know that, but oh well. And that actually brings me to another big difference, is that the Buran has jet engines. So it can like have powered flight when it lands, when it comes in, which is really weird. Like, I don't know what you would need that for. Like, you come in and then you're gonna go, oh, I guess it's an hour to Moscow. I guess we could just go there and have a beer. I don't know, it's kind of weird that they have jet engines. You could probably glide it down, but either way. We've just done a re-entry, and we have fired up two of the four jet engines. Actually, we fired up our four, but we don't have enough air to get the bottom two. We don't really need them, they're really just aesthetics. So we're just coming into a very cluttered runway. That gets fixed, and it's also pretty laggy, so apologize for that one. This first landing is a bit laggy, but nevertheless, we can see it come in. This was not the first attempt at this landing, which is why there's kind of a weird cut a second ago, but here we go, coming in, and ooh, what a landing. This craft has major issues landing, so we'll talk about those more a little later, but for now, let's just focus on our space station. So we're just finishing up our first launch. Like I said, we have seven launches, and then we are going to get going right away. As soon as this thing gets stopped, we're going to recover. I do go ahead and clear out most of the area around the runway and launch area, just so it's a little bit easier and less laggy in my space center. It's a lot less cluttered too. Alright, so there is launch number two. Alright, just in the air now, and I just had officially confirmed that my payload was in there and not like exploded. That's standard Soviet procedure right there. Alright, so we're tipping over, doing our gravity turn. Yeah, those four boosters just got launched off the side. Those have skipper engines. Probably not the best idea, but I just kind of trying to just get the look right. Now we're just getting into orbit. Now, when we detach the side boosters, the core is just very unstable. It wants to flip over. As you can probably see, the RCS thrusters are going pretty crazy. Hey, go ahead and do our injection burn there, and we can go ahead and do a docking and get rendezvoused with the station, which we are now. Or it's not really a station, it's just kind of a thing floating in LKO. Okay, so now we're going to open it up. This launch, we are bringing the power generation module, one of the two of them with the solar panels on it, because it had no electric charge. Like, we ran out of electric charge very quickly. I turned off SAS off. I turned SAF, SAS off, rather, so I didn't think it was going to burn electric charge, but it is, so that's just kind of dead floating there. So we need to get power generation up to it. Not a very graceful docking, but I mean, when do I ever do graceful dockings? It was a little bit more challenging because it was a just a random hunk floating there that can't really have anything, so we have to like kind of, attack it. And I had to kind of give it a nudge to flip it around there. And then we can go ahead and do the stocking and get the first set of the solar panels on. So in order for them to fit in the cargo bay, we had to get a robotic hinge and kind of fold it inwards. That was the only way I could get it to fit on the shuttle. So we're gonna, or the Buran rather. This is the superior version. I'm gonna go ahead and open that up, and you guys can see how that thing looks. Kind of interesting that it kind of moves the entire thing. I guess that's kind of realistic. And then we can go ahead and get all the solar panels out. I went a little overkill with the solar panels, but I mean, hey, they look cool. All right, coming in for re-entry number two. We're not gonna be going for the runway this time. We're just going for some random place. We're doing seven launches. I would be here all day if I had to get to the runway every time. And there we are, spinning out of control. And here we are to the landing issues. So, full disclosure for I believe this landing and the next landing, I used cheats. This actually is gonna give me too bit of a rant. So, the landing gear is so broken in this game. Like, if you watch them deploy. I don't have any of the crashes in here, but it'll just randomly explode. I can land perfectly smooth and everything will just explode. I don't know if that's a glitch or that's just me being horrible, but there's no way. Like, at most, you're getting the impact is at most 2 G's, and those pieces are taking way more than 2 G's on re-entry. Even on, like, maybe not way more, but even on takeoff. Like, we got 4 G's, I think, on the when we have all the engines firing. Like, it should not be structurally breaking or anything. Like, it can handle that. So, for this one and the next one, I have unbreakable joints on. Full disclosure, theoretically, as we proved in the first one, we can do it. But it was just such a faff. And it's the next day! And we're launching our next one. Eventually, I actually do get good at it, and I am able to do it without. I mean, maybe. If you guys, maybe it'll be a challenge. Try and land it 5 times in a row. It'd take a while. Don't do that. I'm just double checking to make sure my cheats are out there. And there it goes. We are just RCSing our way into orbit now. Now we're launching the third launch, which is going to be the other power module. Well, it's the exact same payload, just to get it on the other side. So it's a pretty easy payload. These are the lighter payloads. After that, we are going to have to get the communications and all the other big hunky stuff on to the space station. So there we go, we have rendezvoused, we can get the RCS out, tons of RCS on this thing, so we can just go ahead and do the docking, no problemo. Now that the station has electric charge, it can actually point towards us, and the docking is absolutely no problem, perfect. And then we can just get that thing out and deployed, and then that is our solar panels done, our power generation. That actually looks like a base station. So now we are just going to do re-entry. Here we go. Now this is the only one I believe I did have to use the cheats on, so sorry guys. Here we go, coming in. Yeah, there we go, just turning on the cheats. And this landing really wasn't even that bad. I don't know. Look at that. Piloting skills. Come on, float city, where is the landing? Kind of running through trees, but trees are not important. Mother Russia. Neither are parachutes or drogue chutes at the back. All right, there we go. Just bringing it to a stop, and then we can get ready for our next payload, which is going to be the end section of the main core. So the space station, what I launched first was the main core. Then we're going to have two kind of other side top bits on the side of it. You'll see when I get up there. But we're doing our next launch, getting that gravity turn. This thing, you have to start the gravity turn really late. I started at about 5 kilometers just because it's very, very unstable if you start it below then. You just don't want to. It's going to be flipping out of control. So I just wait till we get. I just point radial out until 5 kilometers, and then when we get a little more stable, there's less air resistance. And then, you know, less atmosphere screwing us up, we just go ahead and start that gravity turn. Now, the core, when you have all the engines on, it has a pretty high TWR, so we kind of pitch over real pretty quickly. So that's just, it's an interesting takeoff profile. And another thing to complain about with this thing, I have a lot to complain. Let's take this. This took me hours to record, hours more than I wanted it to, and I was planning on it taking hours. So hopefully, you guys, hopefully the result, the end product, was pretty good. I think it was worth it. I'm pretty happy with the station. So there we go. Just opening up the next module, and we can have a look at the top module, or you can see that's going to be mounted to the end of the current station. And we can go ahead and detach that, and we can go ahead. This thing only has 30 units of monoprop, so it's going to be a little more tricky to do the docking, but it really shouldn't be a problem whatsoever. And we are just maxing out the payload capacity of that Buran right there. Just go ahead and get our separation nice and close, and then we can go ahead and do the docking of the next module. This is launch number 4, so that's going to be 4 down, and then we're going to have just 3 to go after we do this landing and docking. So this one's a pretty uneventful docking. Just going ahead and bringing it to together. Cool. Now we can just go ahead and fade across to our reentry. And I believe this is where I kind of figure out how to land. Actually, I really think I just got lucky in terms of, you know, not crashing and not exploding. Yeah. So here we go, coming in. This thing can survive reentry, no problem. And then we just come in. And also lucky because I landed on the super flat area. And we go ahead and deploy those landing legs. And I don't believe I did it first try, which is where the reason for that fade there was. But I did it close to first try. And this thing can actually come in fairly slow. It really starts to drop when you get below, like, maybe 80 meters a second. Ploop! I'm really amazed that that didn't blow up. If anyone knows why this goes on, please inform me. And you can just go ahead and stop it. The one thing I was going to kind of complain about was the maneuver nodes are really whack with the thing. Like, really whack. Like, it never... The maneuver node goes all crazy. It's just one of those things. A lot of craft are like that. And some of them are, like, more organically shaped with weird stuff. It's just... It's weird, but we're on our next launch. These launches are going pretty quick, so I have a, you know, I'm struggling to keep up with the commentary. So this is going to be the same module again. We're just going to mount it to the other side, so we'll have a pretty much a complete main fuselage after that, and then we will just have only 2 more to go after this one. So we are progressing quite nicely, trying to get into orbit and do another rendezvous. These rendezvous go by so quickly, I really don't have time to talk about them. So if you're looking for a rendezvous tutorial / docking tutorial, this is not the video for you. And there we go, just doing our burn now. And going ahead and getting ourselves set up for the docking. Go ahead and attach our booster there. Now the booster, I actually did put engines on it, or landing legs on it, and a probe core and all that stuff, so it could land. But the way I have the engines mounted, the mastodons, it's impossible. So basically, since there's off-center thrust with the, since, you know, there's a big, you know, Buran hanging off the side, and there are no engines helping it counteract its weight. So naturally, the rocket wants to tip backwards. So what I did to counteract that was when in the vehicle assembly building, I mounted the engines a little bit off, so they're pre-tilted a bit. So that helps us stay stable during the launch. But on when it's just the main core and there's no off-center thrust, and oh yeah, I just completely broke that. We don't need to talk about that. We can just skip over to the good one where it actually works. It becomes impossible. The thing just flips out of control when you try and deorbit it. I really couldn't find a solution to that, so we're just going to have a bunch of these boosters hanging out in orbit with quite a bit of delta V. Actually, there's like 2,000 in each of them. The thing is way overbuilt, but I was just going for realism and not for like accuracy or efficiency or whatever. I just wanted to build a good craft. And here we go. Just coming in to land, and I believe This was like the second try only, so that was good news. I'm starting to get it down at this point. Coming in, coming in. Really does like to float. And it's always those wheels, like the larger extra large that I have. Oh, look at that landing. If it weren't for the bounce, you know, like the 15 bounces would be a lot better. The landing gear work in mysterious ways, in my opinion. In these later launches, I actually mounted the landing gear a little differently because I thought that might solve it. It kind of did. It made it a little bit easier to land, but basically instead of just mounting them on the bottom of the wing, I mounted them on the fuselage and then just offset tooled them over. Alright, now we're up to the second to last launch. Now this piece is the communications array. Pretty important piece. If you want to communicate with your station in it, communicate with other people. Although, not probably isn't. It's mainly an aesthetics thing. This is a sandbox save, so it really doesn't matter. I could just always disable comm network. And, well, that's a little cheaty. But, you know, the command pods, you know, it's an aesthetic thing. I have all sorts of, like, I have things that you wouldn't even need for that type of station out, like in all the different communication dishes. So, it's an aesthetics thing. Okay, now we're just coming up on the craft. See the RCS going kind of nuts there. As we slow down, we can detach the Buran, pop open the cargo bay, and then have a look at the module. And then we're just going to go ahead and fly it out. And then we are going to have a more or less done station. There's only going to be one payload after this, and then it's a pretty exciting payload. Not really, but it it's an interesting one. You guys have to stay tuned for that. There you go, do the docking. Absolutely no problem. Pretty chill. And plop. So, now we can go ahead and do the re-entry of the Buran. And this time I said, hey, I've been on a good streak for the landings. What if I just bring it into the runway? Just try and go for it. And would you look at that? We are just going to get there perfectly. No spinning out of control. Okay, maybe a little bit of spinning out of control. Oh, a lot of spinning out of control. Well, either way, it looks like we are going to be able to make it to the glide. Glide it back to the runway. And I don't think there's supposed to be a fade there, but I did this first try. I was just dropping out of time lapse there, so sorry about the fade. I could change that, but I've already been editing for over an hour, and I want to get this uploaded. So live with it. Okay, coming into a stop. The thing is really nose high, so that's kind of interesting. That's just how it worked out. I don't think that's how the real one is, but I don't think the real one has that many wheels either. But oh well. All right, final launch. This is it, guys. We are up to the final launch. Just doing the normal thing, pitching up 5,000 meters, and then there go the boosters. There comes the debris raining back down on us. And then we can go ahead and try and match our orbit with the space station, which doesn't have a name. So if anyone has a name for it, all I'm calling it right now is LKO station. So if anyone has a name, please comment and let me know what you think it should be. Or if you don't care, don't comment and don't tell me. Because if I were you, I wouldn't care about me. I've had some pretty nice comments recently, though, guys. So if you left a nice comment, that was very nice of you. Thank you very much. Go ahead and detach the Buran, and there is our payload. It is just a Mark II cabin. Because this is a part one. Oh my gosh, guys, this is a two-part series I'm doing. Two-part series. So this space station, while it looks done, it actually is not done. This new piece I'm adding is going to be a place for where the final and biggest piece is going to be mounted. So please do stay tuned for that, because what we are going to do is we are going to take an SSTO and we are going to launch 500 tons of fuel into that station, because this is a refueling station. This is going to be a refueling station, guys. It is that awesome. It's going to be refueling. We're going to get 500 tons of fuel. We're going to get 9 of the 3.75 meters all on there. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be epic, and I can't wait until that, which is tomorrow's video. So stay tuned for that. That'll be tomorrow's video, like I said. And if you're watching this in the future and you don't know when tomorrow is, it is, well, in the past for you. Now let's go ahead and tumbling. I overshot the runway, but we have the jet engines. Like, NASA never thought of that. What if, you know, what if they overshot? They can't use the jet engines. It's almost as if NASA planned for things. And I don't. So, we're coming into land now for the final time. Very excited to do this. And then the plane was just not working with me during this landing. But you guys don't get to see any of that. So, I'm just going to do some fades. And you will just magically get to see me do the landing. Like, see, look, first try, guys. That was definitely first try, wasn't it? Obviously. So, coming in now. Got it lined up. Got it. Bring it in real slow if you don't want it to explode. That's one thing I learned. Nice and slow. It's okay if you land a little bit hard, but horizontal speed, from what I've learned, is most important. There it goes. Welcome back to Kerbin for the final time with a more or less completed, it's a fully functional station, just doesn't have the fuel yet. Stay tuned for that though, guys. So that is going to do it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Until next time, please rate or comment to this video. Once again, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. And bye.